Hi, this is Anne with SVG Cut File, and today I'm going to show you how to download a font from Etsy, install it on your iPhone, and then use it in Cricut Design Space. And this does involve adding an extra app to your iPhone. All right, let's get started. Okay, first we'll go to the App Store. That's right here, and it looks like a big A. And then we're going to search for iFont. And it's this one that's kind of teal and blue. I've already downloaded it once, so I get a little cloud here. But yours will probably say get. So just go ahead and push that. You'll probably have to enter your password here. It'll take some time to download. And then once it's done, you can just hit open. If you have iOS 14, you're going to have to take some extra steps here. And that is what this warning is saying. So we'll X out of that. And then choose Start Using iFont right down here. Next, you'll need to download the font that you want to use from Etsy. So go to your Chrome app, not the Etsy app, and type in Etsy.com. Then you'll need to log in. So go ahead and do that, and then you'll see a little picture of you or a little like generic picture up here. Go ahead and click that, and then come down here to Purchases and Reviews. Scroll down and find the font that you purchased, and then click on the little picture next to it. I don't actually have a font that I've downloaded, but I do have this little picture, so this will kind of be like a font. And then scroll down again, and you'll see a button like this that says Download Files. You'll see a file here that ends in OTF that has a little cloud beside it. So you'll want to click that little cloud. And then it'll pop up like this. It'll be the OTF file, of course, and you'll push download. Next, you'll want to choose Open In, which is also right down here, and then scroll down and choose Save to Files. Then I'll choose On My iPhone and Save up here in the corner. And I already have one out here because I was running through this earlier, so I'm just going to push Replace. But you probably won't have to do that. Okay, now let's pull up from the corner here and go back to iFont. And under the Installer tab, which is this first little button down here, choose Find Fonts to Install, which is this blue button. And at the top, you'll want to choose Open Files. And then you should be able to scroll down and see your file that ends in .otf. I just put this one on here for my own files. So let's click that. And then we'll come down here to the Installer and then choose Install. I've already installed this font, actually. So I'm going to go ahead and install this one. You'll get a message that says this website is trying to download a configuration profile. So go ahead and choose Allow, and it'll say that the profile is downloaded. And so go ahead and close this. We'll have to go out to our settings next. So pull up from your corner and then go to your settings app. At the very top, you'll see profile downloaded. Just click that and then install up here in the upper right. You'll have to enter your passcode, and you might need to click Install again, and then Install at the bottom, and then just choose Done. Next, we'll go to the Cricut app. So pull up from the bottom right and find your Cricut app. If you haven't installed it already, it'll be in the App Store too. So I'm just going to pull down over here and find it on my machine. So when you look in the App Store, this is the one that is correct. So I'm going to click that, and then I'll start a new project. I'll come down here to Text at the bottom, and I'll click on System, and then search my fonts. And the one I want to find is the Pokemon font. And there it is. And now we can just type something. And as you can see, oops, that was supposed to say hello. As you can see, our font is installed and usable in Cricut Design Space. So yes, it's actually quite a process to get a font from Etsy to iFont to Cricut Design Space. But if you don't have a computer, this is the way you'll have to do it. All right, if you like this video, just click on the like button, and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.